We've been talking, now let's talk.
I've been teaching here for 10 years. I started at in the pre-K classroom. I was a pre-K collaborative teacher. In the last 5 years, I've been teaching kinder. I was diagnosed in 98 with kidney failure. I started showing signs back in 95 where I played volleyball for Eastwood, and I had to get a physical. When I went to get my physical, they found protein in my urine. So 2 years after I graduated, I started feeling really sick. I was getting a lot of headaches here in the back of my head. So I went to go see a family doctor, and by the time I went, I had already lost 75% of my kidney function. He sent me to a specialist, and the doctor there told me that I was going to be needing a kidney transplant.
I got a phone call at about, 12:30 a.m. And it was my brother. He said, I need you to come to the hospital. And he said, Adriana's been in an accident. And I got to the ICU, and I asked for her, Adriana Cruz. And the lady said, she's upstairs in ICU. So my immediate response was relief. She's in ICU.
I got a call on a Sunday morning. At the end of the phone call, they told me that I need to get to the hospital because they might have a kidney for me.
My dad was leaning up against the wall, and I just looked at him, and he shrugged his shoulders, then he shook his head.
We kind of had an idea of where the kidney had come from. The only thing the doctor could tell me was that it was from a 29-year-old female who passed away in a motorcycle accident.
Somebody from Southwest Transplant Alliance asked us to go to a room with them. They said, we want to know if you would consider donating her organs. And we just looked at each other, and I looked at my dad, and he said, sí, no más, los ojos no, is what he said. And I looked at him and I said, why? He said, porque tiene muy bonita la mirada.
She saved my life, and I don't even know this person. I don't know, and I couldn't even imagine what the family was going through at the time, where I feel like I'm celebrating because I have that second chance. I thought, this family's in pain. This family's hurting.
I know that we made the right choice in donating her organs, and I don't think we ever questioned whether or not it was easy to make the decision, because my sister was such a loving and giving, beautiful person, and so we knew that she would have done it. I don't know that we've ever hugged that tight, and I think it's probably the very first time that I felt like my sister. I felt Adriana, but I could feel her. And it's been a very long time.
Oh, no, yeah, you are. You really are.
Because I don't want to take anything for granted.
No. It was a beautiful feeling. Because the first thought was, she's in there. She's literally in there.
And I told him I was pregnant and it was going to be a girl, and I asked him if it would be okay if I named my daughter after their daughter, Adriana. She's 10 years old and her name is Adriana Luz Licon. They made the choice to save somebody's life, and they've impacted my life very greatly. It's been 19 years since I've had my kidney, and my life has changed, and because of them, in those 19 years, I married, I went to school, I got my degree, I graduated with honors. I was Teacher of the Year here at Sageland. I had my baby, which I've always wanted, was to be a mom. And it's just, all of those things wouldn't have been possible if they hadn't decided that day to donate their sister's, daughter's, mom's organs. Her dad had told me that he could not listen to the song Amor Eterno since his daughter had passed away. And I told him that that's the song that I would wake up every morning to as my alarm.
She's never taken a moment for granted. Her naming her daughter after my sister is just another way for her to keep living. And just in your tragedy, you can really make a huge difference for someone else. And in a sense, you're preventing that family's tragedy.
If I had not received the kidney transplant, I probably either would be dead or I would be on dialysis for the rest of my life.
I'm grateful that the organ went to somebody so beautiful